A big red car drives on a long, long road. In the car is a farmer, John.
I'm very, very tired.
He is hot and tired. He wants to go home and have a bath. John listens to the radio in his car and he sings. John likes singing. Sometimes people like John singing, but not very often. The song he is singing is called Hot, Hot, Hot. There is a sign on the side of the road. John reads it, Cairo, Egypt, 72 kilometers. Tehran, Iran, 136 kilometers. John must drive for a long time. His home is about 100 kilometers away. He rubs his eyes. The sun is very hot and the road is long. John does not want to go to sleep, so he sings some more. A kangaroo hears him and jumps away. John laughs, then rubs his eyes again. Just then John sees something. Suddenly he is not tired, and he is not laughing. The hair on his head stands up. There is something on the road. He stops the car and gets out. The thing is a long way in front of John. He cannot see what it is, but he does not like it. John gets back in his car and drives slowly. The thing is moving, it is alive. What the? John says quietly, it's a man. What's a man doing here? He thinks there must be something wrong. John stops his car 10 meters from the man and looks out. Hello, says John. Are you okay? Are you looking for something? The man does not move or speak. He is looking at the sky and smiling unhappily. John looks up too. He can see nothing. There is a gun in John's car. He looks at it. I must be careful, he thinks. John drives 5 more meters. He can see that the man is about 40 years old. He is wearing a good suit, but it is old. Hey! Are you okay? John asks again. Can I help you? The man moves his head slowly to look at John. He says nothing then begins to walk. John watches him for a minute. He thinks, I must do something. Where are you going? Shouts John. There's nothing on that road. Do you have any water? The sun's very hot. Can you hear me? John does not know what to do. He cannot leave the man here. What is wrong with him, he thinks. Is he ill? A lizard runs across the road. A big bird flies near the man. It looks down, hungrily. Near the road are some bones, a dead kangaroo. John is afraid, but he cannot drive away and leave the man. The man looks very tired, so John drives 2 more meters. Do you want to die out here? There is no answer. Get in. I'm taking you home, says John. He opens the car door and gets out. He moves very slowly and talks very quietly. It's okay. You can come with me. Get in the car and sit down. I have some water in the car. John helps the man, and he gets into the car. He is very dirty and tired. John gives him a drink. The man is thirsty and drinks a lot of water. Stop, says John. Don't drink all the water. A little now, then more later. The car drives fast on the long, straight road. The two men sit and say nothing. John listens to the news on the radio. There is rain in Adelaide. A man in Sydney is 125 years old today. A kangaroo is learning to talk. And a very white light is in the sky near Woolloonga. John likes the news. Next to him, the man sleeps. John looks at him. The man wears an expensive suit and nice shoes. Why is he out here in the sun, without a hat? They drive for an hour before they get to John's house. John leaves the man asleep in the car. He goes into the house and tells his wife, Emily, about the man. Emily always knows what to do. We must find out who he is, then phone his home, she says. Let's look in his pockets. Perhaps there is something with his name on it. John and Emily go to the car. They find a wallet in the man's pocket. There is a name, John Phillips, and a telephone number. There is also some money. This money is 25 years old, says John to Emily. Why has he got old money? John Phillips, says Emily to the man. You're very interesting. John suddenly opens his eyes and looks at her, smiling. John picks up the telephone and calls the doctor. He tells the doctor about John Phillips. I think he's ill. He's very tired and doesn't talk. He doesn't know who he is. Can you come quickly? The doctor lives about 200 kilometers away. He must fly a plane to visit John. I'm coming now, he says. Asterisk, look out for me in half an hour. John puts the phone down. Okay. Let me talk to his wife, says Emily. She takes the phone and calls the number. Somebody answers and Emily talks for a long time. John hears her say, but he is here. No. It is John Phillips. We have his wallet, his name is in it. Hello? Hello? Are you there? Oh. What? When? I don't understand. Okay. Thank you. Goodbye. When she stops talking, her face is white. She looks at John and says, "This is all wrong." John Phillips is missing, his wife says. For how long, says John. 30 years, says Emily. His wife has a new husband now. They have 3 children. The flying doctor is late. After an hour, he arrives in his plane. I'm sorry, he says. This is a new plane, but sometimes it doesn't go very well. I must take it to a mechanic. But it doesn't matter now. I'm here. John tells him everything. The doctor asks a lot of questions, then goes to see the man. John Phillips is looking at the plane through the window.
"Hello, John," says the doctor.
"I'm a doctor, and I need to ask you some questions. Can you remember your name? Can you remember where you live?" John does not answer. The doctor talks to John and Emily. He says, "John hasn't got any broken bones, but I'm not happy about him. I want to take him to hospital." They put John in the plane next to the doctor. "Phone us," says Emily when the doctor gets in the plane. "Phone us from the hospital." Soon the doctor and John Phillips are high in the sky. Suddenly John speaks for the first time. He talks slowly.
"I don't want to be here.
I want to be with my friends. They are looking for me." John stands up in the plane.
"Wait, you can't do that," says the doctor.
"Sit down."
John opens the door and says to the doctor, "You can come too."
"Do you want to?"
"What?" shouts the doctor.
John looks into the doctor's eyes. The doctor cannot move. He cannot look away. It is cold on the plane, but the doctor is hot. John's eyes are looking straight through him.
"Come with me.
It's a good place. It's better than here."
"How can I?" says the doctor quietly.
Then John jumps. The doctor looks out of the window. John is falling down, down, down. But the doctor can see a smile on his face.
"He isn't going to die," thinks the doctor.
He knows that. There are small trees below the plane. Cars drive on a long road. Kangaroos jump all around. John is very small now, and he is falling fast. John is 20 meters above the trees. A kangaroo looks up, but John is not falling anymore. A beam of light stops him and takes him away.
Up, up, up.
The doctor closes his eyes. The light is very, very white. When he opens his eyes, the light is not there. John is not there. The doctor sees something in the sky. Then there is nothing. He is very unhappy, more unhappy than ever.
"I want to go too," he says.
Roy Cole is a mechanic and he works in an airport. Today he is happy. The sun is nice and warm. Tomorrow is Saturday, and this weekend Roy is buying a new car. He is excited. He is eating a sandwich when he hears the plane. He looks up and sees it in the sky. The plane is coming to the airport. It gets very near. In the plane, Roy can see a man.
"Who is this?" thinks Roy.
"I don't know this plane." He puts his sandwich in his pocket. The plane stops at the airport and a man gets out. Roy begins to walk across to him. The man stands still and looks at the sky. There is a small smile on his face.
His suit is dirty, and he looks tired.
Oh dear, thinks Roy, what's the matter with him?
Roy likes to talk to people.
He smiles, then talks to the man.
Perhaps I can help him, he thinks.
Hi, I'm Roy, who are you?
Roy puts his hand out, but the man does not move.
Roy puts his hand in his pocket and looks at the plane.
Roy says to the man, wow!
What a wonderful plane!
It's more than 30 years old.
It's an old flying doctor's plane, isn't it?
Suddenly the man looks at Roy and says, flying doctor.
Yes, that's right.
I'm a flying doctor.
A flying doctor?
Of course you are, says Roy with a smile.
Where do you live?
Where do you want to go?
The doctor begins to get into the plane again.
Then he stops and looks into Roy's eyes.
Roy hears him say, I live a long way away now.
I must go back.
Do you want to come with me?
Suddenly Roy feels hot. The doctor's eyes are looking straight through him.
How can I, says Roy.
I can help you.
Get in my plane, says the doctor.
Level 1, Beginner. Basic vocabulary. About 300 basic words.
Congratulations on your dedication and good luck.
Text read in American English.
Level 1, Beginner.
End of text by Easy English Abreu.